Jesus, we got all we need. Amen. Amen. We got all we need. Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
We'd like to invite you down to our church. We have church every Wednesday night at 7. Every Sunday night at 6 at Curry Branch Holiness Church. Just take the parkway towards Manchester. Get off the exit. Go right. About 4 or 5 miles or so on the left, you'll see the sign. It says Curry Branch. Amen. Come down and be with us in any or all of our services. Amen. We appreciate the Lord. I'd like to read tonight from 2 Chronicles chapter 20. 2 Chronicles chapter 20. We'll begin reading with verse 20. And they rose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, Hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so shall you be established. Believe his prophets, so shall you prosper. When he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, and that should praise the beauty of holiness, as they went out before the army, and to say, Praise the Lord, his mercy endureth forever. And when they began to sing and to praise, the Lord sent ambushments against the children of Ammon, Moab, and Mount Seir, which were come against Judah. And they were smitten. Amen. Let's pray if you would. Father, tonight we thank you for another opportunity to stand and bring your word. Thank you, God, that tonight we have the opportunity, Father, to bring your word out to a lost and dying world. Pray, God, tonight, Lord, that somebody could get help tonight, Father, we pray. If anybody out there is lost, God, that they could be saved. Lord, these requests that's come in, ask God that you touch them. Lord, that you move on them, strengthen their bodies and heal them. Lord, we love you and give you the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. I thought tonight here, the enemy come against Judah and against Jehoshaphat. Now there was three cities they had band together, and they come against this small city, and they began to get worried being such a small place against such a great number. I thought, friend, we're fighting against principalities. We're fighting against spiritual warfare. We're fighting against the rulers of darkness. I told them at church the other night, last night I said, Amen, we're fighting against the God of this world. Who is the devil is what the Lord said when he was on earth. But I thought the three cities had come against this small city, and it looked like that they were going to overtake them. Amen, but Jehoshaphat and the people began to pray, and he asked the Lord, Amen, to come by, and he began to fight. And to seek God. Amen. And he rose up in the next morning and he appointed the people and the singers, and they began to praise God in the beauty of holiness. Amen. And when they began to sing, the Bible said that God sent ambushments down among the cities and they began to kill one another out. And when Jehoshaphat and the people come towards the watchtower, all the enemy lay dead. Amen. And they could rejoice in the Lord. I'd like to tell you tonight, you may not be able to see his hand moving. You may not be able to feel him working, but he may be working when it looks like you're up against the end. When it looks like the battle is just about over, God's working where you can't see him. Amen. I like to say, my God, I work second shift, third shift, and first shift. And when you're asleep, he's watching over you. And when you're awake, he's keeping you. And when you're at work, he's shielding you. Amen. And things you can't see, God's working in. Amen. He's working in tonight. The problem may look like it's too much. It may look look too heavy. You may feel like you can't go another mile. But God's behind the scenes, friend. Amen. A working. I've had them talk to me about things, Brother Jonathan. And I'll say, just go ahead and go on about your normal routine. Amen. And I'll be seeing what I can do to help. Amen. You just go on about your normal routine and let God do the work and take care of it tonight. There's nothing impossible with God.